All right, we're going to try one more thing with the rope real quick. This is actually my wife's favorite trick. She likes this one. And, you know, earlier we had a little tribute to Harry Houdini, which was known most for escapes. But he was also known for walking through solid objects. You know, they would put him in a jail cell with stone walls and steel bars, and he would apparently come through them. Now, we don't have those kind of apparatus here tonight to set up a jail cell here on the stage, but I'm going to try to do something in the same category. I'm going to put this rope behind my back. Derek, would you grab the very end of that rope? And Matt, would you grab the very end of that rope? And I'm going to get where you guys are about even. Perfect. Just like, it's important that you are exactly the same distance from him that he is from you. Very good. All right. Now, we actually want to get this rope right up against my body like this. Now, you all are kind of working for the audience because you all can see all the way behind me, all right? They can't. And so if I cheat, if I step over the rope or if I put it over my head, you guys would know it more easily than they would. So you've got to make sure it stays here at my waist. Got it? Good enough? On the count of three, gently, not a tug of war, but on the count of three, gently pull that rope forward. One, two, three. Go. And just like that, it comes right through. Guys, drop the ends of your rope. Do you guys know each other? You guys know each other? Okay, well, shake hands and pretend you're meeting. I needed that as a time filler in this part of the show. I'm not done with you yet. This part is going to... Oh, I lost my wind guard. I'll put that over here. Our pure sonic will be after me. All right. We're going to try something really, really special. In the first half of the show, we did Houdini's Straitjacket Escape. How many of you enjoyed the Straitjacket Escape? Somebody told me last night that was their favorite part. And it's not my favorite part, but the audience likes it, so we keep that in the show. But I wanted to try something more my own flavor. This is something I do enjoy. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, for your viewing pleasure, right here on this very stage, right between Derek and Matt, I'm going to escape from my very own suit jacket. That's about how much response that gets everywhere we go. No, I tell you what, it would be pretty easy just to take this off, and so I'm gonna put some handcuffs on. If I've got the handcuffs on, I can't slide the jacket off of my body. Make sense? All right, and so I've got some handcuffs. Now, these are not just any handcuffs. These are the kind I saw hanging from Derek's rearview mirror out there on the parking lot. Is that about, no? Was that Matt's car? Would you take those and check them out? Make sure they're real, make sure they're solid. And while he's doing that, I also have a couple of brass and stainless master locks, little padlocks, and I got these over at Lowe's today. They don't know I have them, but they were very helpful. Would you check those out? Make sure they're real and solid. They lock, they unlock everything they're supposed to do. How are those? It looked pretty ordinary, very solid, very good. You've got those, they look good as well. All right, and gentlemen, I will step inside of the curtain of death. Or the curtain of love. It's a red curtain, whatever you're more comfortable with. We'll put that right here. Now, here's what I want you guys to do. If you'll come together right here in the middle, I'll take these because I want you to handcuff me inside. Now, don't get the two links on the end, then it would be loose. And so you hold those exactly. You act like you've done this before. We do want blood flow. We just don't want me to be able to get my knuckles through. Very good. Good. Like that? Okay. Hey, you guys got me in there good. I tell you what, let's do this one behind my back. That'll make it a little more fun for the audience. They're having a debate about which link. Folks, tonight's show is going to be a little longer than most of them we've had over the weekend. I'm really enjoying it for some reason. You guys were in a contest to go on the road with me. You lost. I tell you what, check those one more time. Everything look good? Look solid? Very good. That looked good. And you've got the key. Now that's important because you are my emergency man. If anything goes wrong, you've got to get me out with those, okay? Do you have a pocket to put those in? Very good. Gentlemen, you will notice some rope handles on the corners there. Would you grab those rope handles? And then stand up, but just let them hang down to your sides. Perfect. Very good. Now, what we're going to do in a few moments, on my command, you'll take the curtain up as high as you can. And you'll pull against each other slightly, just so this stays nice and tight across there. Basically, we're trying to hide the escape inside of the curtain so we don't give away the secret. And so on my command, you'll take it as high as you can. And then on my command, you'll drop it back down to waist level where everybody can see. All right? Now, we're going to do a test run, but real quick, I've got no key, anything like that. All right, gentlemen, here's our test run. Take that as high as you can and hold it up in the air until I tell you to bring it down. Go ahead. Very good. And that is perfect right there. Pull it back down. That's how high I want you to take it. You'll have it right here. And then you'll thank you very much. Very good. He said, how did you do that? Very well, I thought. Thank you. All right. This time is for real. This is not a test run. I'm really going to try to escape from my suit jacket. Derek, Matt, would you take the curtain all the way up and hold it there until I give you the command to bring it down? And bring it down. I am halfway there. This is world record time, so I had to give you a little progress report. Thank you, both of you. Okay, here we go. Try not to stand on the curtain of death. All right. This is good. It is, isn't it? I was thinking the same thing myself. I don't know why that most of them didn't clap for the last part. Here we go. Guys, I'm going to try one more time to get all the way out. Take it all the way up. Any time would be fine. And just keep it in the air until my command. You know, Houdini, they said he could dislocate his shoulder to get out of these. I can't do that, so I'm dislocating something else. Guys, pull that right back down. This is the wrong direction. Thank you very much. This is like one step forward and two steps back. Okay, I think I got proud. My big head got in my way. Take it up one more time. And this time, I'll do my best to get all the way out. We'll see if we can pull it off. And, oh, drop it to the ground. Just completely let go. All the way to the floor. You are a strange and sadistic audience. I'm glad you find this so amusing. I've never been in so much pain and had fun at the same time. You're feeling that way right now, aren't you? Now, I know what you all must be thinking. You're thinking that these locks are not really locked. Derek, did you want to take a look and verify? All of a sudden, he's not wondering how I do it. Matt, did you need to? Guys, I gotta get out of this. Take that curtain up one more time. Hold it way up. I'm gonna try this time to get all the way out. And guys, drop it one more time. I think this is about as good as I can get it. Derek, would you take that jacket off of my head? Thank you very much. Drop the curtain. Can you put that microphone back on my ear? Yeah, just go after it there. Perfect. Thank you. I heard Pure Sonic Pro is hiring. You might want to get a job. Ladies and gentlemen, I have escaped from my suit jacket. Now, guys, real quick, just so we know everything is on the level, would you check that one more time? Everything is still just as tight as we started. Everything is intact. No key. Everything look good? There? All right. Well, thank you very much for your help. Derek, thank you very much for your help. And another big round of applause for the magician. Give these guys a big hand. Y'all can take your seats. Thank you. I will. Thank you very much. Give them another hand. They put up with a lot.